And welcome back to Monster Hunter 1. I am Sebastian, or Lieke, whatever you want to call me. Yeah, Monster Hunter 1, and I'm sorry if I haven't actually made any episodes recently. I have been pretty busy with different stuff like commissions and art, and yeah. Today what we are going to do is basically we would want to take some sepal scales and stuff like that, but the issue here right now is that for the sepalos helmet and the whole sepalos set, we actually need 25 sepal scales all in all. And you can imagine that if you get like one or two sepal scales per quest, then it really is just way too it's just not worth it basically right now. So yeah, that's a thing. We might not actually make sepal armor at any point. Right now, at least, we need matchlight doors to upgrade this one. And yeah, I was told that Stoic Deviant, actually, on the podcast that I was in, told me that these weapons are not categorized or anything, that they're just like, yeah. There are moments when I'm thinking about maybe I should start using a bowgun or light bowgun, but I'm not sure right now, at least. Not so sure. We can actually make a longhorn, which is a good weapon, I think. Yeah, pretty good. I will actually make a... Why can I make a large monster bone 1, small monster bones 10, match light doors 2. Is it worth it, really? Do I need to, like, give matchlight doors right now? Oh, well, it's not worth it right now. So what we will do on this episode, we will actually do some capturing and encounter a new monster for us to fight against as well. So I will take these at least. And we will go out to a quest. I'm sorry, these, like, the beginnings of these the start of these episodes are very lengthy, I think. Slay the Gypsers. So yeah, the new monsters have appeared pretty much. Gypsers, we are not ready for him at this point. Yeah. What we will do though is catch an Iankutku. The reason we are going to do this is basically, and the only reason we are doing this is for you guys to see how catching is going to work on this game. So this guy will give you some Wyvern tactics and how to work on different stuff. Yeah, so we will take our medicines, medkits, and trap tools, and yeah, tranquilizers. This is actually a good thing that Monster Hunter Tri or Ultimate doesn't give you at all. I will actually go through all of these right now. If you want to, just pause the game if you want to read those. So yeah, Monster Hunter Tri or Ultimate doesn't actually give you any trap tools, which we can see in here. This quest actually gives you one trap tool that you can actually, in the quest, you can actually hopefully combine it to a... into a... pitfall trap. So you would need to gather up spider webs and ivies, which you will actually get a lot in this map. So yeah, it's possible to make at least one pitfall trap if you don't fail it. If you fail it, then it's pretty much a done deal at that point. So catching a Jankutku, this is going to be fun. Alright, there he is. But there's some cats, so I don't really want to fight against him here. So I guess he goes to area 10 from here, which is full of Velocitromes, I think. Velociprays, actually. Hopefully not, though. Hopefully not. Yeah, we'll see. Is he down here? Yeah, there he is. There he is. Oh my god. Mossan 1 is actually quite different from Monster Hunter Tri or Ultimate, because this monster is actually just, even though I have said this earlier, especially Kutko, he doesn't actually give you any signs of when he's like going to attack you or anything like that. It's just, he does things and you just have to like learn his way. The safest zone for Ian Kutku is beneath his feet, much like Sepalos had. The only pretty much place you want to hit is the stomach. On both the Kutku and Sepalos, it depends on your weapon. If you're using a hammer, you are more go for the head basically, because that's going to take the head takes more impact damage than it does cutting damage. So I might have been a little bit wrong about that on earlier episodes, but yeah, that's fixed right now. Capturing a monster is also something. I'm sorry, the camera is just not working with me right now. Something you need to learn about the game. And this is a great, great quest for that, basically. The reason for it is that, well, maybe this quest isn't actually a good quest to learn to trap a monster. Or maybe it is, but Kutku is the only monster in the game that actually shows you visually that he is actually ready to be captured. Like, every monster, of course, they limp to show you that they are ready to be captured, basically. So they kind of are slower and they walk very like they have a hurt leg or something. So Kutku actually lowers his ears, as I have said before as well. So he lowers his ears when he's ready to be captured. So that might be a reason why I don't think that this actual quest is actually like that good of a quest to. Oh my god! Stop charging at me, please. So this might not be a good quest to. For you to learn how to trap a monster, but just remember that when you feel like you have done enough damage, as long as he is actually alive, then try to buy as much time as you can and see when he leaves the area. You will see if he is going to limp or not. So yeah, we are fighting Kutku again. How many Kutkus have we been like fighting against this past? Oh man. Sometimes I hate Monster Hunter 1 so much for reasons like these. The camera gets stuck all over the place, and the especially the environments on the game sometimes, like the bushes and stuff like that, very annoying and gets in the way too much. And yeah, that's something they actually fixed in. So now he's ready to be, as you can see, he's limping right now, so he's ready to be captured. And basically at this point what you would want to do is actually try to paintball him, because he's going to leave the area. And yeah, but from 10 he actually doesn't go to any other area than 3, so he's going to be in 3, hopefully, if I'm not mistaken. Please come here. Oh my. Oh my. Is he in 4? He might actually be in 4. That might be reasonable. No. Okay. So he goes to 9, which feels very odd, because I don't actually remember that any monster goes from 10 to 9. But I can't remember everything in this game. And I'm sorry if my English is somewhat bad in this episode. I haven't been speaking English that much. Oh my god, he actually left this area as well. Yeah, that's the thing. Let's try to find it out. Hopefully he's in here. Nope. So he might be going to sleep, so because he's limping. So he goes to sleep in area 5 at least. That much I do know. So yeah, he was here, so he is going to sleep. So you might want to do at this point what you want, what you would want to do at this point is to wait for him to land in area 5 and then go inside, and when he's sleeping you could trap him pretty freely and so forth. There you go with the pitfall trap. And yeah, oh come on Kutku. There you go, and we have captured it. And Maxilators, please, Maxilators. So yeah, that's how you pretty much capture a monster. Some of you already might have. The mechanic, it hasn't changed at all. From Monster Hunter 1, except that on this game you don't actually have any. God, this velocipede, seriously. Just leave me alone. You don't have any shock traps on this game. So yeah. And voila! Velocipres. I hate you so much. I hate you so much. So much. Do we have any? Nope. So yeah. That's Kutku captured, and he goes to sleep, and pretty much now we can get a lot more Kutku materials, basically, if we capture them. Flame sacks, for example, you cannot get them. I haven't gotten any flame sacks so far, so you might be needing to capture him rather than killing him. And my English is very bad right now. I'm sorry. And we are back. Oh. Yeah, this is going to be some. Oh. Stop it, you stupid cat. Some annoying. Oh my god, you can't be serious. So it's going to be very annoying. Seriously, cat, stop. Going to be annoying to gather some materials, especially for the armors, because this game actually is very different from Monster Hunter Tri and Ultimate and even Unite. Even in Unite it was very easy for you to gather up some materials and stuff like that. So yeah, what I would want to do is upgrade this weapon. We need so many. Cat, you don't need to go outside. Stop. So yeah, the cat's actually been very annoying for the past week or so. It's just, yeah, it's very loud for some reason, and I don't actually know why. What should we do? We have mega potions, so yeah, this episode is just going to be pretty much me going on different quests, and yeah, nothing like important. But I'll try to. Oh, 20 velocity praise, IO praise, velocity draw. Oh, wait. Oh, man, it's in jungle. Oh, man. I guess we can. Let's do the 20 IO praise so you can actually see what IO praise are like. I know that I actually. I said that the IO praise are the ones in the desert zone, but those are actually gen praise. Gen praise, basically. And they, as I said, they inflict status. Status like paralyze. And these guys inflict poison. So, yeah. And there's Kutku, I think. Yeah, Kutku is in here. So these are IO praise and. Yeah. Oh man. How many hits do I need to. Oh, I don't want to, like, seriously. Kutku and IO praise, not my day right now. Nope, nope, nope. I rather just kill the IO praise. Yeah. Like these guys. Alright. Now, let's see how many hits does one take. Alright. Is that enough? Yes. Oh man, just stop it. So we need IO prey hides basically. And IO prey stuff for now, I guess. I'm not sure if I can make the armor set from these guys, or do I need the IO drone actually. As well, the bigger version of these guys. And as you can see, they spit out poison as well. But we are also here to gather up some materials, not just IO prey materials, but also the matchlight doors. So these respawn. Oh, that's awesome. No, wrong direction. Oh man, seriously, just stop it. Please. Oh man, I hate these guys, seriously. And it's not just IO praise that I hate. And you might be wondering why IO praise and especially every gray in this game, why they are annoying. You might realize at some point. Yeah. Very, very annoying. We need to kill 10 of these, I think. How many have we killed? Let's see. 4. And we need to kill 20. Oh my god. Alright, let's just kill these guys. Just die, please. Oh my god. I don't want the poison effect. I don't want the poison effect. Seriously. So yeah. This is what we are going to do for now. I actually thought that I would do the Sephiroth's armor off screen. But it ended up being very tedious because you get 3 cars from him and mostly you get Sephiroth's fins, which you need only 5 of in the whole set. And you need 25 scales and you get like 1 scale every time you kill the whole or Sephiroth. And yeah. You can actually farm scales also in from the Sephiroths, the smaller ones. You can actually farm them as well. But even that can be very, very tedious for a while, even without, or especially without sonic bombs. So yeah, these guys. God. Oh, man. All right, let's go to the next area. Perhaps that's a little bit easier. I don't even know why I'm, like, losing stamina so fast. Is it because of the caves? Oh no you won't, cats. Oh no you won't. I think that the caves... Could it be in this game? I have, like, a small recollection that it actually might be that the caves in this game do actually inflict, like, faster stamina depletion. So, that might be a thing. Oh man. Io pray, why did I take this quest? Alright, 10 killed. So far. You do get a lot of stuff from this quest. So it's not like... Or you might get actually like very bad luck as well. That could be a thing as well, but I think that most of the time you will get a lot of IO prey stuff from this quest. And I'm not sure about the armor, how good it's going to be. Hopefully I will get it done at some point. I don't even remember if there is an IO prey armor at all. But we'll see, I guess. Kutku is coming. What a coincidence. My pronunciation of English is very bad at the moment. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Alright. Ugh, this camera. God, you're annoying. So, in the future when I'm going to make Monster Hunter Try videos, hopefully I will be making them from the perspective of all of the weapon classes, so that I won't be playing with just one weapon. I will show you how to fight each monster with each weapon and stuff like that, but what goes for Monster Hunter 1 is that it's so damn annoying to get all the weapons to same exact level basically. So I would be spending way too much time to upgrade a single weapon, and then spending even more materials to make another weapon basically. So in Most Hunter Try and Ultimate, it's very easy to get the materials you need for each of the weapons. It's very easy. Yeah. And five more. That will probably be the episode right there. I'm sorry, these are very tedious quests. Not something you would want to see, but I feel like I should get something out of them. At least until I get to fight against bigger monsters, because even though I would like to play the game off screen and get the materials, by the time I get the materials, it's already been like 2 or 3 days, and that's like 2 or 3 days out of videos from YouTube, basically. I don't know if I make any sense when I speak English this badly, but yeah, when I play off screen, it's just I'm not recording it to YouTube or anything, and you guys are going to miss some stuff. So I rather record at least something than nothing. So yeah. Seriously. These guys are so annoying. Yeah, that's amazing. I don't know what happened, but something died. That's good enough for me, I guess. And yeah, I'm not like able to play every day this game, even though I like would want to and bring more stuff to you guys. I just have so much more stuff to do as well. Yeah, of course. So in this game, basically, if you can't carve it for on the first try, don't even try to carve it anymore. Now, die, please. There you go. Finally, we've done it. We got, what did we get? 7 fangs and 6 scales, 3 hides. I'd say that's not worth it. That's definitely not worth it. Oh yeah, definitely. So caves in this game, yeah, I don't actually remember there being that fact that if you're in caves, you actually lose stamina a lot more faster than in normal outside air, basically. Drink some tea. We'll see if we do something else after this one as well. I'll just have to know that if we can make any Ioprey armor or anything along the lines. So yeah, did we get a lot of stuff, as I said. Ioprey fangs, scales, hides. A lot of hides. So yeah, as you can see, the money in this game is like very hard to get. To get this, of course, if you want to farm money, you could do the Sepatrome quest because he's kinda easy to fight against. So you could do that one and you get like 2 or 1,500 zennies from that one, and yeah, you could just farm that one and get your money that way. Attack of the giant bugs, 3 Vespoids. Even that is annoying. I'm going to check the armor head. So here we are with the Eye of Prey. Alright, doesn't seem that bad, I guess. What does it give? Doesn't give actually anything. Man. I think I'll make an Eye of Prey armor, at least. But it's going to be annoying. What else can we do? We have the iron pickaxes. I'll just buy the old pickaxes as well. And then we go to do Aegypter's Land Shark Attack of the Giant Bugs. Alright, we'll do this one. This is the last quest we will do. For this quest, you might want to do a bowgun or a sword and shield. If you can make a sword and shield, which you should be able, if I'm not too, if I remember correctly, because there is a sword and shield line. I think it's in the bone line. Where you can make a poison sword and shield, and doing the poison sword and shield, you can actually poison these Vespoids and make good use of them, basically. Because right now I'm just hacking away these guys, and yeah, they won't give me anything right now. But we have another objective on this quest, basically 30. So imagine this. On Monster Hunter Try or Ultimate, you kill like, what is it, 10 Vespoids. You get a quest that you have to kill 10 Vespoids at maximum, or maybe 20. And this is a low rank quest and you already need to kill 30. Oh my. Is it these guys that we need to kill? I think it is, actually. It might be these guys. Yeah, these guys are fun. So the armor you get from these guys is actually pretty good. You should be able to make them. Or if you are able to make them. Just poison these guys as well, and yeah. The armor is pretty cool looking as well, even though it's big bulky armor basically, but I at least like it somewhat. Alright, so it's Vespoids, not these guys. That's fine, I guess. These guys are here just and only to make you feel annoyed when gathering ore. But yeah. What else? I'm currently saving up some money to get a HD recorder to record some Wii U gameplay. So that's going to be a thing. And also this microphone that I'm using is only for me. I have loaned this from a friend. So I might lose this microphone at some point, and I'm sorry for that. And yeah, so I might have to change my microphone at some point, but yeah. I actually have maybe two microphones, but both of them are pretty bad. Pretty bad, and I don't want to bring YouTube any bad quality videos. Other than my English skills. It's already bad enough, so you don't want to hear me speak on a bad microphone. Some people don't actually mind it. I'm one of those people that I want my material on YouTube be at least look somewhat good and sound at least decent. I don't have even a decent microphone at the moment, so. Or at the moment I do have, but if I lost this microphone, then it would be a different story. How many best points? 11. Keep that in mind. 11 best points, because we don't want to kill them all right away. We still need to gather up some. Some stuff. Alright. And again, we can carve. Yay! 7 more. Alright, let's keep that one in mind. 6. 5. Oh my god. So yeah, these guys can actually paralyze you, but as you can see, it's 4. 3. Alright, that's good enough, I guess, for now. Yeah, the paralyze effect or status effect isn't like that high that it doesn't actually annoy you that much, but it seems like it's made deliberately so that whenever you are carving or finished with a hunt and a Vespod comes and bites you or stings you, then you're going to get that paralyze effect. That's how annoying it is, basically. Oh. Yeah. Totally. Awesome. Just die, please. Yeah. That's the thing. I can't actually get my iron ores because these guys are being annoying. You guys are annoying, you know that. Right, is there one more? Oh yeah. Turn the camera around. Nope, these guys just keep on invading me. Yeah, just get at least one. Nope, nope, nope. Oh my god. Alright. This is what I'm going to do. I will throw a stone, take a mega potion, and throw a flash bomb right there. Hopefully it works. No, it doesn't. Take the iron ore. Yeah, there's nothing else here. Yeah. Yeah. So that happened. All that time. I want one more. And yeah. Alright. You give me something useful, please. What can be more annoying than bugs in this game? Actually, nothing more. Yeah, let's just kill these guys and be done with the quest and be done with playing the game as a whole. I'm not going to play this game anymore. Like, seriously, these guys, very annoying. Please, no, no, I'm not gonna let you get any iron ores or anything. I'm just gonna stab you in the back. Yeah, there's nothing else here. Good. Alright, so that's that. Hopefully we get something useful out of this one. Oh man. Two consecutive annoying quests, basically. First 20 IO praise and second 30 vest points. The vest points ain't that annoying, but these guys, man, you should just, please, just die. Die, you dumb, I don't know if you're Alathrions or something. What are you? I don't even remember your name. I don't remember your names at all. So yeah, that's pretty much the episode. I'm sorry if this was very bad English of me. Yeah, that was a sentence. Oh god, this is getting very frustrating right now. So yeah, I was planning actually making the Cephalus armor and perhaps continuing towards new bigger quests, but as it is right now, I'm just not in the mood to gather up 25 Cepatrome or Cephalus scales. So yeah, now we get another armor up and ready, which is the Vespoid. There you go. You can probably see in the info that it's the first armor so far that actually gives us a plus resistance to something. Alright, so this one actually does give it, but alright, I'm sorry. Yeah. Actually trying to see, like, alright, weapon improve, can I improve? Nope. You I can improve, but I just don't want to. I might as well do the longhorn at this point. So, large monster bone, small monster bone, match light door. Alright. Let's do that one and you will see the and a match light door. Yeah. We'll see how it looks. At least. Hopefully I can upgrade it once more. Great. Longhorn. And improve. Can I? Please. Medium. Only medium monster bone. Alright. So basically this is the bone lance that you will make in to make a Diablos horn. So we need these ones to upgrade it. Hopefully we have enough money. No, we don't. So what I will do is sell some stuff again. What should I be able to sell at this point? There's not much I want to sell. Like, seriously. These guys, I guess. One of these. Right now I don't need good gears, so I can sell one of those. You will need good gears, I guess, for a bowgun. So yeah, improve this one. Longhorn, yes. How much? Oh my god. I can upgrade it. Oh my god. 700. You must. Alright. I'll sell all my good gears. No, I won't. Something more useful, I will. Or not useful, but something I can afford to lose right now, which is these guys basically, and right now I can actually probably do that, and what else can I sell? Now one of these. Is that enough? I don't remember. I don't remember. I want to upgrade this weapon so badly. Improve. No, it's not enough. Oh my god. So yeah, improving weapons in this game can be very tedious and takes a lot of money. Considering that the amount of money you get from quests. Kelby Heights, I guess I can sell. And I'll just sell 5 of these as well. So now I should be able. I should be able to upgrade it. We can improve. This has been a very easy upgrade so far. Yeah. So you can make a monobloss. Monobloss lands out of this one, or the barbarian tusk. Crimson lands basically is a monobloss lens. Yeah. You will probably go with the barbarian tusk. It will reduce the damage quite a lot. Unlike the Crimson Lance, which also has an element. Here you can see actually the first element weapon, which is Crimson Lance, which will give you fire elemental to it. As powerful as the Diablo Horn, designed for attack power. Yeah. We might be able to do that at some point, hopefully. I'd rather do the Crimson Lance than the Barbarian Tusk for this lance, at least. So yeah, this lance is actually quite a bit longer than the Paladin Lance. Even though the Paladin Lance does extend from its original position, it doesn't extend as much as the Diablo's Lance. Or the bone lance tusk, whatever it is. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this episode. We made a weapon and did some stupid quests. Whatever, I don't care anymore. I'm getting very tired playing Most Unwanted. That doesn't give me any items that I would want to get faster, a lot faster. So yeah, I'll see you guys on the next episode. See ya.